This is the second part in my tutorial for converting a board game to the touch table using Unity. In part 1, I set up the project and imported assets. In this part, I'm going to set up the cameras, which will render the scene, and the canvases that the game elements will be placed on. Links to part 1, more detail about part 2, and assets needed for the project are below. Unity automatically creates a main camera to render the scene. This is like the player's eye in the world. I set the main camera's size to 10 and the clipping planes to 1 through 100. These settings don't matter much, but are good defaults for a 2D game. We need to add the aspect utility behavior. This script adds black bars to the top and bottom or left and right of the screen if the screen resolution doesn't match the desired aspect ratio of 16 to 9. Duplicate the main camera by pressing Ctrl D and then name the new camera Animation Camera. Change the clear flags to Don't Clear, and remove the audio listener, since we only need one of those in a scene. The Animation Camera will render all the moving pieces in the game. Having a separate camera is the easiest way to keep 3D elements above UI elements. Next, I'm going to create the canvases. I use two canvases for the main menu, called Main Menu Canvas and Load Canvas. Create the main menu canvas by right-clicking in the hierarchy, selecting UI, then Canvas. Set the render mode to Screen Space Camera using the main camera, and set it to Pixel Perfect. The Screen Space Camera setting places the UI at a fixed point on the Z-axis and in the 3D world, which allows us to mix UI elements and 3D objects. The canvas scaler should be set to scale with screen size with a reference resolution of 1920 by 1080, and should have a screen match mode of expand. Copy the main menu canvas by selecting it and pressing Ctrl D. Call this the load canvas and set its layer order to 1. This will render the load canvas over the main menu. For the game itself, I use three canvases. The game canvas, where all the non-moving elements of the board are drawn, an animation canvas for all the moving elements, and a dialogue canvas for dialogues and pop-ups. The game canvas and dialogue canvas should be rendered by the main camera, while the animation canvas should be rendered by the animation camera. The game canvas and animation canvas should be layer order 0, and the dialogue canvas should be layer order 1. Everything is basically still rendered in the order it is listed in the scene, with the multiple cameras needed to keep 3D objects and effects above the UI elements. For now, set the game canvas to inactive. The first time that we create a canvas, Unity makes an event system object. This object handles mouse and touch input and passes mouse and touch events to the UI elements. I don't change anything in this object. The main camera had an audio listener behavior. This is half of the audio system. To play sounds, we also need to add an audio source. To do that, let's create an empty game object at the top level and name it controller. Add the reuse script called audio player to that object. Adding the audio player behavior will automatically add the dependent audio source behavior. The audio player script works by holding an array of audio clips and provide static functions to play those clips. For now, set the number of clips to 2 and add the intro to the first and the click to the second. Finally, save the scene. That concludes part 2. In the next video, I'll set up the main menu so that players can join the game and pick a color.